Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep. In this video series, we are talking about indifference curve analysis for the advanced segments. Alright, in the previous video, we talked about how a consumer's preferences would change with a change in their income. In this video, we shall take a look at substitution effect. So without wasting any time further, let's get started. So as you can see on the slide, a substitution effect basically would give us information about how consumers would react to various changes in the prices of a particular good, holding their utility constant. In more technical terms, if you're supposed to define this or you're supposed to write a meaning, then this is the segment that you need to write. So a substitution effect would refer to the changes in quantities of various goods due to a change in their relative prices, the real income of consumer remaining constant. It simply means that when the price of a commodity decreases, it is obvious that it would become relatively cheaper to other goods, and this would prompt the consumer to substitute the cheaper good for the more expensive one. However, this change in consumption will occur mostly because of a relative price change in the price of the commodity rather than a change in his income. All right. Now, technically, substitution effect could be studied in two different manners. One is given by Hicks and one is given by Slutsky. In this video, we shall take a look at the Hicksian substitution effect, which is this. Let's take a look at how it is represented on a diagram. Now, in this diagram, we are again sticking to the same old commodities that we've been using throughout the series, which is chocolates on the y-axis and pizza slices on the x-axis. All right. Now, AB is our initial budget line, whereas IC is the initial indifference curve, and E is the equilibrium point where consumer is consuming OX quantity of pizza slices. All right. Now, let us assume that the price of pizza slices falls. Let me write that down. The price of pizza slices falls. On a general notion, the quantity of pizza slices purchased by the consumers would go up, but it would be considered as a substitution effect only if the consumer is able to hold the utility derived from it as constant. That means the consumer's level of satisfaction while purchasing these additional pizza slices should not change. All right. And to show that on a diagram, let's first make the necessary changes that go along with the changes in the price of a given commodity. Now, since the price of pizza slices has gone down, by now you should be aware that a fall in price would make the budget line rotate outwards. So let's rotate the budget line outwards and then see what happens. Okay, let us say this is our new budget line AB1, and let us say the consumer is at equilibrium. At this particular point, let me name it as IC1. This point is E1. Now, all those who have studied the price effect video would know that the movement from point E to E1 is generally categorized as price effect, because the change in consumption occurred because of the change in the real income of the consumer. All right. Now, in this case, the utility did not remain constant because the consumer moved to a different IC curve, which is higher than IC, indicating that the utility just went up. We are supposed to assume that the utility remains constant, and that would be possible only if the budget of the consumer contracts. If you are aware about the changes in budget line due to changes in income, we know that a reduction in budget would bring down the budget line. It would make it shift downwards parallel to it. It doesn't look parallel. Let me draw a budget line that is parallel to AB1. Let us say this becomes our new budget line, indicating a reduction in budget. This is A2. Let me name it as A2, B2. And this budget line is tangent to the previous indifference curve at point E2. Now, at E2, a consumer is consuming, let us say, X2 quantity of pizza slices. So this movement from E to E2 satisfies the condition where utility is supposed to remain constant because the consumer lies on the initial indifference curve now, which is IC, all right? The black indifference curve. Let me just elongate a little bit. So this equilibrium point, E2, is showing us that when the price of the commodity, which is pizza slices, fell, the consumer is increasing his quantity of pizza slices and thereby replacing it with a commodity which was chocolates, which was relatively expensive to pizza slices. This movement from E to E2 is the substitution effect. All right, let me just jot that down. So this movement here is the substitution effect. A lot of students might be wondering, why did we bring the budget line down? If we do not contract the budget, then in that case, it becomes difficult for us to assess whether the change in consumption was due to a change in the consumer's real income or because the consumer wanted to substitute a cheaper commodity for expensive one. All right. So this shift in the budget line here to the green one indicates that we are reducing the income availability of the consumer so that we could eliminate or completely reduce or remove the change in the real income. And hence, we are able to study that with the changes in price alone of a given commodity, the consumer would be substituting it more. One thing we need to remember is the more flatter the convex segment of the indifference curve, the greater would be the substitutability. The more convex it looks, say for example, let me just give you a small visual representation of it. So let us say the curve is a little more indented like this. In those circumstances, a movement from one point on the indifference curve to another would be very small, right? And if it is a flatter convex curve, movement from one point to another would be a big one, right? The more the convexity, the lesser would be the substitutability, all right? Students, if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please do subscribe and share the videos, whoever you feel would be helped with these videos. I'll be releasing the notes for the first segment, which is the cardinal utility analysis, on my Facebook page. So please go ahead and follow me on my Facebook page as well. The links would be available in the description box. If you do not find studying through long videos comfortable, convenient, or you get easily distracted, please go ahead and follow me on my Instagram channel where you would find the reels for same topics and you'd be able to learn it in a much smaller time frame. All right, so I'll meet you again. Until then, bye now. Take care.